Now app. And before we go, we have a significant milestone to mark on this programme. Viewers will be aware at this stage that this is the last bulletin that this man here beside me will be presenting. On behalf of 6-1, the 6-1 team at the moment, and 6-1 teams going back decades, and I know that's going to make you feel really old, Donald, it falls to me to say thank you. You've been a rock to us. You've been our anchor, figuratively and literally. I'm not going to look at you now because I know I'm going to get all teary. From my point of view, you've been a great friend and a mentor, and I'm sure the whole country joins with me this evening in wishing you the very, very best. Now, we mined the archives for your best bits, as they say in all the reality TV shows. There were too many to mention, too many to fit into a single package, but we did put together a flavour, if you like, of Dubbo through the ages.
Hello and welcome to the programme.
I'm mad about a boy.
For millions of black South Africans, the moment they have waited for has almost arrived.
You reaffirmed your commitment to the Stormont talks. Smaller parties and independent candidates, they are witnessing a moment in history. It's decision day for the American people.
Hijacked aircraft crash into the World Trade Center in New York. Good evening and welcome to 6-1.
Pope John Paul II is this evening lying in state here at St. Peter's Basilica.
There was no written agreement to work friends.
There are no documents to support this. Change has come to America with the election of Senator Barack Hussein Obama. Do you feel any shame tonight to be the Minister for Finance who's presided over the arrival of the IMF? Queen Elizabeth II has honoured those who gave their lives in the struggle for Irish freedom.
We're still in the hunt here and we haven't given up yet.
The German Chancellor Angela Merkel today characterised Ireland's response, and I'll be reporting from Rathenesca on the final day of the ploughing championships. President Michael D. Higgins has begun his historic state visit to the United Kingdom, commemorating 100 years since the outbreak of the Great War. The UK votes to leave the European Union.
About the boy.
Thanks for Wilson. Have a great evening. That's really, I'm just completely taken by surprise. First of all, thank you, Sharon, for your very kind words, and wonderful working with you and Paul and everybody who's been on the programme now and over the years. It's been a blast, really has been fantastic. I'm looking forward to Pastures News, so I'll be on the radio more in Ireland from Wednesday and next week. So as I say, you know, I hate to go, but I'm afraid I have to leave.
Yeah.
Okay, so thank you and good night.
I'll see you tomorrow.
And this evening, heavy showers will give way to settled conditions.
Hello, very good evening. My heart is racing too after watching all that. Well done, Dubbo, and good night. And I'm very happy to report some easy weather for the next few days as high pressure settles over the country, bringing most